G'day guys, welcome to Lower Bracket Round 3 in a 2v2 Awarded War Open. We're here again to see 5TA up against Omega CLS. 5TA did take out the previous game, and now it's Omega CLS's last chance to stay in the tournament. So as allies, Great Britain, Tedessa, Konix Tiger, Soviets, Simon as Japan, Liam as Germany, Elite MG Call from Liam. Gonna be a nasty opening for anyone who approaches the center point. The MG43 may be able to rip some guys to shreds, and they will. Konix Tiger still trailing far behind. It's quite interesting how the Elite MG got there so quickly, especially because it's slower, but nevertheless takes out a few, and grenades to follow up Simons as well. Looks like that is actually a regular squad by Konix Tiger, and wow. Those grenades didn't actually hit its mark, but they kind of made the troops go back and allowed the MG42 to rip shit up. Konix Tiger DP27 MG4s to go back, the only surviving guy in the squad. Simon is now approaching to the spawn area and may be able to grenade Konix Tiger's last guy. Nope, MG actually is relocating to guard their spawn flag, though they do take the eastern point, Konix Tiger, and will rout out all of Simon's guys from this side. Very empty area at the moment for Omega CLS. Whilst on the western side, we have a nice push by Tedessa, taking advantage of that situation. Oh, this is going to be a nasty grab. The SMG can get it off. No, it doesn't. That was a flaw. That's a cluster right there. And the Elite MG and well. Nice in grenade rifle shot. There are a huge amount of access forces. Simons and Liam taking back their spawn flag. So they've switched all their power to this area. Now Elite MG has been relocating again, I think, to the center. Yep, just to guard it. Elite Marksman by Konix Tiger pushing in straight into the fray. Though they are caught out in the open with their pants down and will move to the cover of the rake. But now they're in pretty much SMG range, where the SMG MG42 will slaughter them. And wow, Konix Tiger is definitely sending his infantry to death in the opening 2 minutes of the game. Whilst on the western, Tedessa now is sending more reinforcements from the assault squad, while that assault counter-attack by Liam is starting, though I don't think it will go too far. It's fizzling out now, there's not many troops left, and looks like Tedessa will hold that point. 6-0 so far, 5TA holding the lead, and looks to be quite strong at the moment, even though massive losses in the center by Konix Tiger. Sime is now approaching the eastern, taking advantage of a bit of a change of flag, and now we'll be able to catch Konix Tiger with his pants down. Now he's sending just some singles, probably to spot. Doesn't look like he's going to attack that flag back. Maybe just put some line of sight in the area just in case they get flanked. And the center to the east, we've got a pretty strong hold now. MG in the position of ambush with a few other rifles to distract. Wall Econ by Tedessa coming to the center will be what they need to pick off the guys in cover, especially that MG42 Elite MG. So instrumental for Omega CLS to take the center and hold their right side. Very interesting to see openings like that work in the mod. Wall Econ. Now MG's scurrying away, afraid to get picked off. Definitely the priority target, and he knows that, but shit, nearly got collateral damage right there. And 20mm of their own, Liam Flak 38, perch on that hill, going to pick off the guys off the stone wall. Tedessa relocating to the back stone wall, where I don't think the 20mm has range on. And looks like they're going to try an assault on this flag. Liam pushing up with a recruit squad, Volkstrom, as the Germans. And it doesn't really have good range, to be honest, to push and help this point, because it really needs to come from this side in a flank. They do have the forces that could potentially make or break that assault. Center. Wall Econ. Still taking a while, actually, to clear out the center point. The ducking proving to be quite annoying for 5T8, though they're now storming in now. 4-8 at the moment. Sneaky guy from Tedessa. Rifleman, can he get taken out before he caps? No, he's actually gone back into the fog of war, and the troops aren't shooting back at him. Ear grenade launcher. Tedessa taking a shot. Direct control. Boom. Misses its mark. Olicon still not hitting stuff. It's just hitting the stone wall, missing everything for some reason. It's just not doing too well. Chihi out from Simus. Insta kill. One shot. Olicon down. Failed. Perfect. What you want. Counter. He learned from the previous game. Not going to Chihi. Ha, just waiting a little bit more, 60 MP more, just to have a secure, I guess a secure, more secure counter, just in case there's a 61k. In the meantime though, the allies are showing a bit of form. This is where they shine, bit of one special point, infantry killing action, shock infantry. Japan, where's that one special from Japan? Oh, that's a crash. Hang on, I've got to reload, damn it. G'day guys, I think I crashed around this point. The Orlikon just got killed by the Chihi. I'm just going to hang around this area here just because I crashed somewhere when I was looking there till about 5 minutes 30. See on the minimap, a nice swarm from Liam coming into the western point. He's taken it just by sheer weight of infantry to their assassinating militias, which will most likely be stopped in its tracks. Just want to have a bit of a rant about the crashes. I pretty much crash every second game in a car, so 50% of my cars crash. And it's very frustrating and annoying. I don't know why they are not fixing it or cannot fix these grenade crashes or whatever crashes they are. Yeah, totally interrupts the flow of the cast. Oh well, what can you do? So Liam now moving his flak in a nice position, going to the right. And has rain of this side, but not too much else. You could potentially put it up on the hill with it and then move it back down if some sort of counter comes. It's a pretty good area to play. Center has been taken back by 5T8 by a few guys only, whilst the eastern wow, SSD by, so haven't seen that one for a while. So I was bringing back, and he actually does really well. He killed a lot of his own men though, and it's right click, left click, right click. Oh no, this guy might get it. No, he's getting flamed instead. Throw the Molotov though, he'll get the Molotov off, and oh, it burns it. Oh, unlucky. That's one thing I find funny, that when a unit gets flamed, if you action the grenade action before it got flamed, it will continue the grenade action when it is flaming. So very interesting there. Chihi now in an unfortunate position, tracked and cannot respond or reverse or hide, and it's going to be put away easily by 57. So cocky, doesn't even care about angling because he knows it's that's the Chihi with its mini pea shooter. Two special points. Guard sniper from Königsteiger, his choice of two specials from Soviets. Sam is managing to claw his way in to the center, and now both of them do cap the center point. Sniper's being split. You can see one to the left, one to the right. Decent play to the Königsteiger 57, shooting at something, shooting at the building for some reason, trying to take out the guys behind the wall perhaps. On the western, a huge amount of forces from Tedessa with a half track ready to counter that. Wow, how did that flak die? Sorry guys, I missed that. Flak has been taken out, so another half track is free range. But here's the Panzerfaust from Liam. Ooh, that's a huge ditch. It's gotta sneak around, maybe. It's gonna wait. Just be patient, mate. Here it goes. Shot. Boom. Nice. Does take it out. SDG 44 is out, but not firing back. It's still on hold fire from that Panzerfaust. And unfortunately, does not survive. Western point will go now to Tedessa. Sniper is relocating again. Now perhaps once they cap this area, it can move to a better position to shoot all the way down to their spawn flag. Interesting pack 36 by from Liam, the mini AT gun, potentially just for that half track, but didn't. I guess it's a fallback plan for that Panzerfaust. It probably could have failed. And an interesting line here. I saw a red dot in the past in the minimap, and looks like these guys did a good job to spot the sneaky 5TA. 5TA dodginess. Home guards from Liam. It's definitely the choice of two special points for Japan. Now having a bit of a defensive line to hold this point, though I find it's quite easy to cap anyway. Just gotta play a bit of grenade. Annoying grenade handsies. Bit of proning action here, throwing grenade. Then you have the flag, regardless of what's up here. And the sniper right there is going to be instrumental in finally in securing this whole area, as these home guards are going to get picked up bit by bit. Sam is already knows about it, and straight air prone is this guy. And 557 as well coming up to play. Sniper still doing work, will pick up these guys slowly. No counter yet. He's got the mortar out though, Simus. That will definitely counter the sniper. Hasn't been proved to be very good in the hands of Omega CLS. Last game, wasting three mortars, just getting run over. Hopefully they do better this time. A little bit better, easier to guard, I think, on this map. It's very open, so you can kind of have plenty of shots and plenty of time to kill a charging light vehicle coming for your mortar. Whereas on Italy, there's lots of hills, the vehicles can do a bit of shenanigans, rolling behind whoa! That guy's tank just exploded. Went flying to the left. Bad luck there, Connect's target. That flamethrower would have been so good to have in this engagement, shooting over that little small decline. Connect's target does manage though to take the point just with sheer weight. Snipers have definitely pinned down the MGs protecting the flag, and now the shock infantry, if they had the flamer, it would have just gone all the way down here as well, flamed everything. As another MG felled. Reconnaissance from... interesting, reconnaissance by from Simers. Potentially getting some spotting action on the sniper, and then getting the mortar to train its sights, or to train its... angle on it to fire. Chinu from Simers. Interesting buy. Amidst the 57 being on the field, it will be very hard to fight it. Not known to counter 57. 57 can fell a Chinu more than the Chinu can. Chinu hiding in the backfield on hold fire, though Königsteiger is going back as well. Oh no, he's going forward now. So we're just waiting for a bit of Tedessa's troops to come in. No. Looks like he's just going to wait. Chinu is turning its side. I don't think he sees it though. It's pretty far. Probably around, yeah, it's way too far to do anything. Well, AT grenade rifle took out so many somewhere. T-60 out in the center. They got tank domination. This is where it's going to shine. Oh, AT infantry from Simers. Can it sneak that? It's a bit too far. Oh, but the T-60 is getting very close and is in risk. Oh, misses. Bad luck. Should have waited a little bit longer. There was a little bit of rush shot. I think there was, he was eager to take that shot off. But perhaps a bit of patience may have proved to be the T-60's undoing. Chinu coming at the flank. That T-60 gonna go hunting. Now T-60 hiding behind that tree. Oh, track on that T-60. And it's gonna be fouled, I think. Chinu's penetration too powerful. There you go, T-60 is down. Königsteiger now pushing off the take off the Axis Stonewall. And a lot of troops in the backfield. Liam with elite marksman, decent to have in the very back, and we'll be able to kind of pepper away at the enemy and pick, eventually wear them down. Though, best the sniper won't do too well. 57 relocating. Try target that Chinu, which has, well, it is reversing quite fast in advance. Oh, it's coming really hard and fast. It's gonna go for it. It's just wanting to kill it so badly. And first shot doesn't hit its mark, but SMG guy from Simers will take it. Whoa, it's got it. I think, Chinu's came out of that unscathed. Panzer H from Liam. 57 was, wow, so aggressive. That was deserved, in fact. No line of sight in front. Simers easily runs his SMG guy to put away the T-57 with an AT grenade. Chinu now knows it's king of the field, will come out to play again. Sniper is still there. Mortar from Simers used very cautiously in the backfield. Can it rain over the sniper? No, it's 146, needs to go a bit closer to do anything. Perhaps that could be what he needs to do. So far, I haven't seen the mortar kill too much. F1 assault squad guy is the top scorer, taking out 57, then crew AA. Wow, crew AA? I didn't even realize the crew AA was on the field. There it is, right there. They did a lot of damage in the time that 57 duel happened. Mortar trained in the center, Simers peppering away on that area. Crusader AA getting targeted by the Panzer H, perhaps. Shot goes way above its head. Six Panda in the distance. Potentially going to move the hill, move onto that hill to have a nice flank shot at that H. Crusader AA being very cheeky, has a bit of has a good shot on the spawn flag, or not sure if it's a good shot. Does have a shot, yeah. And safe from that H, the building angled very well to protect that Crusader AA. Center fight is still going on, bit of micro from Simers. Crew AA helping out. Panzer H, knocking down the building bit by bit, and be able to take it out eventually. I think Liam's going to keep peppering away on that building till it happens. Tedessa, confident, is just staying there. Six pounder is going back for some reason. Not having much luck though. She's shooting at the wrong area. It's right there. I think he's trying to aim at the building to hit that, but definitely aiming at the wrong spot. Oh, cheeky Tedessa. What is he doing? He's crazy. He's crazy. This Chinu and the Panzer H. It's about to get killed. It's got turreted or main gun or and main gun. Six pounder moving up. Can take it to Chinu. Will struggle versus the H. Moving up very close as the red guards come in from Königsteiger to cap the center point. Chinu backing away. They don't know this expander is here, I'm pretty sure. It's very far from the lines. Though the mortar will be able to take it out as soon as it reveals itself. Expander kind of plonked right in between the center and the west. To maybe bait. Maybe use the Crusade AA as a bait. Yep, it's going to be put right down the center. Mortar still hasn't been doing too much. Elite marksmen have taken the center. Sneaky guy from Königsteiger, 80 infantry, has been spotted though. Mortar not killing much. Sniper from Liam, taking out one of the guys. SNL left, big buy from Simons, upping the ante. The elite of the Japanese forces coming into the center. Machine gunners and what do you call the bazooka? I'm not sure. The AT weaponry as well. Gonna take out Cadessa's AT guy. Mortar as well helping out. Splitting up quite well. Some in the center, some in the left. And they have secured the center. Or will very shortly, but this one guy does take out one before he dies. Six pounder's quite in the open now. I think they've definitely spotted it by now. So only holding on to one flag now. 10 to 59. This is their last chance to stay in the tournament. They need to move on fast. Mortar now moving up closer. Definitely will be trying to take out the six pounder. But I hear a big boy. No, that's just a Crusader AA. Moving to the right. RTA doing so well so far without any tanks yet. H and Chinu's been out on the field for so long and they haven't been counted. They haven't had the need to be counted as really the domination of infantry and infantry killers has been on 5TA side for that time. And the tanks have proved to be, even having this tank domination, hasn't really done too much for Omega CLS. But perhaps now with that flak, will force a tank by, a tank counter, or maybe an indirect counter such as an SPG. Yet to capitalize on this situation, Omega CLS, nice decoying of the flak. It's buying them some time. Chinu going to take a shot. Oh wow, bounces, hits nothing. Crusader Air is going to throw caution in the wind and just run for it, and it will escape because it misses the first shot. And again to Dessa with the six pounder bait. Simons, can he escape with his life? He gets tracked in a decent angle, but six pounder can penetrate it. At this range, he just gets the crew injured. And again, Simons. Simons, this is offensive, but it's just Tedessa has got you chumped right again. The Chinu is going to get countered like a chump, getting baited again. And what a shot. Explodes that Chinu, and the 85 decrews that flak, and it's falling like dominoes on Omega CLS's side. And what else can be felled? Panzer H perhaps from that 85. So he doesn't want it. Looks like he bought. This is the 5TA. 5TA. Quirk. They like to go the shock troops. Six special points. And two 85s. One each. That is a very unique strategy by Team 5TA. Proving that these units are relatively useful, I guess. They come out a bit earlier in the mod at five special points because, yeah, it was never bought in vanilla. Due to its timings coming out just before the Vet Tiger, whereas having it five specials, you can make use of them and they can make an impact for quite a while before the Vet Tiger comes out, if it does. Flamethrower from Liam. I wonder if they did save for the Vet Tiger, as it will be coming out in quite shortly. So I got a bit out of shape. I can't remember the time. I remember it was 20 minutes or so. Flamethrower up from Liam. I haven't actually played the game for weeks. The only games I actually play are the tournament games. So I'm very out of practice still. I kind of lost the urge to just play for fun. But yeah, I still love the game. Love casting the games, seeing tournaments. As the crew AA is coming in to wipe off the S on the left. Who cares if they're elite? They just get insta-gibbed by the 20mm shell. Simon's with the bazooka. Boom! Oh, such bad luck. He just gets the bounce and the crew injured. Another shot for Simon's. Boom! Another bounce again, and Simon's is not going to be pleased. He's going to be raging. Oh, finally takes it out. Nothing to counter the AT infantry. Had a good 3 shots. Mortar. Definitely should target the sniper. Considerable amount of troops, but this sniper must be racking up the kills right now. Got lots more targets around here. Yep, it has been. 43 kills in the guard sniper. Something you just need to counter very quickly. Crew AA is still top scorer for some reason. Interesting. And then you have the assault SMG, which took out the 57. Landing a bit short. That hill absorbing most of the explosive impact. Protecting that sniper. Ho-ha rush with... Oh, this gets totally wiped by a T-60 by and felt. The guys explode. The cartridge explode and guys are flung out. A lot of infantry dead. This is a paratrooper 3 special point call, I think. And the right exact... This is the worst time he could have charged. T-60 coming out at the exact same time that was charging. I don't think he would have saw that. Bit of bad luck. Omega CLS has just lost a big unit. Chiha coming to try take out that 57. T-60 is gonna run away. Can it run? Oh no, it's not. Taking its time, Chiha, for one more shot. Oh, it's still there. What's he doing? He tracks it. Oh, side shot from... Oh wow. Red Tiger! Coming straight down the road. It's been tracked by something already. Tracked by the Cromwell 95, so just tracked, no big deal. 57 or 85 has been turreted. T60 now moving further down. That is not preventing the cap from Simers underneath the hill. 10 to 92, they need to hold on to all flags, which they are. So all, at least 3. Sneaky guy has been spotted. Simers will put him away with the tank crew. Red Tiger still trying to take out that T-34. Oh, sneaky guy Saboteur is actually raided the tanker and may take it the Red Tiger. They spotted him and they didn't follow through. Oh no. Don't crash. Doesn't matter. Oh, dynamite, doesn't matter. Boom! On the engine. Goodbye, Veteran Tiger. Goodbye, Omega CLS. You're out of the tournament, buddies. This is no chance now. 85s are the king of the field with the 95 Cromwell. T-60 somehow died. That's a bit of a reprieve for Omega, but no, they are doomed. They are completely doomed. 5T8, 97 to 10, flags are going to them, and they are through to face off me and Hansy. I'm not looking forward to it, because I am so out of practice, but we'll see what happens. 5T8 are kind of like our kryptonite, because, yeah, they play very defensively and they're the most defensive team out there. But they are really good at it, and we struggle to break them, mainly also because the pings also suit defensive teams where you have time to camp, where the rushing is a bit harder to execute. But there you go. Oh, this is going to be a tough game. Looking forward to playing 5TA soonish. Saboteur, wow.